Come on, let's stand to our feet. We know that a mighty fortress is our God. Wonderful day that thou hast made, a day we rejoice and are glad in. God, we thank you for bringing us into this second month of the new year. Lord, knowing that you've given us the privilege and the honor to ask for more in 2024. God bless us. Oh God, as we give you the praise and the glory for what you've already done, acknowledging, God, that you can do even exceeding and abundantly above all that we ask God. And God, have your way in our service.
Yes.
We're going to give you perpetual praise. We're going to give you perpetual glory and perpetual honor. God, bless those that are here. Bless those that are traveling here. Oh, God, bless those that desire to be here but won't make it. Oh, God, have your way. Lord, as we magnify you, save to the utmost. Heal and deliver, set every captive free. These blessings we ask and receive in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And everybody that knows already done, give God already done praise. In Jesus' name, we pray. Remain standing, amen, for the reading of our scripture, Luke chapter 11 and verse number 10 is our thematic scripture that we've been dealing with, amen, this entire, amen, year. We're going to stay there until the Lord says something different. Amen. How many know you can ask for more in 2024? Come on and tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah to our God. We give God the praise and the glory. Amen. Luke chapter number 11 and verse number 10 is on the screen now. All right, let everyone read. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. God bless the reading of his word. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy. Yes, he is. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is. Come on, everybody. Oh, give thanks. Sing. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is singing. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is. We're singing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is. Come on, everybody. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Singing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. at the end, they ain't gonna give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good, for he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Yes, he is good. I got his word. And he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, the door shall be opened. In other words, as we're singing unto the Lord, we're asking. As we're singing unto the Lord, we're seeking. As we're singing unto the Lord, we are knocking. And I don't want you to miss this opportunity. I don't want this moment to pass by you. Let everything that have breath do what? Let's give God our big praise. Hallelujah. But when I'm praising him, I'm asking for what I want. When I'm praising him, I'm seeking him for what I'm looking for. When I'm praising him, I'm knocking so the door can be opened unto me. Amen. And I'm going to thank him in advance. See, I want to thank God in advance. So we're going to reset and try this one more time. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, yes, he is good. I got him worthy, for he is good, yes, he is good. I got him worthy. Oh, give thanks, you're seeking. goodness of God. We're going to open up a praise and a testimony service that you can give God praise and testify of his goodness. Who shall be the first to give God the glory that he's worthy of? Give him the praise that he's due. Who shall be the first?
Thank you.
testimony, another witness to the goodness of God.
Yes.
Yes.
He wants a free spirit.
Yes.
He wants a free spirit.
Hallelujah.
And for free
forever in a relationship with God. That in spite of what the devil is doing, I see God working it out for me. If you know God is working on your behalf, give him a thank you. If you know God is working on your behalf,
I know the Lord. Please bring your gifts unto the Lord.
Expanded United We Stand. ride on today. Look at the neighbor and say, I'm not an accident. God is good. Amen. I was looking at him. I was thinking about my childhood. It would be, you know, it's the same. Amen. The principle. The old adage is methods are many. Principles are few. Methods always change. But principles never do.
Amen.
Mother Abram, they would call me up and I would say, I'm a promise. I'm a possibility.
Amen.
I'm a great big bundle of potentiality.
Yeah,
right. Amen. And if you ask me, I believe God's word.
Yeah.
Don't remember that. All I'm glad for you is possibility. Come on and say hallelujah. Look at your name and say, I'm not an accident. I'm not an accident. Amen. I'm a great big bundle of potentiality. Luke 11 and verse number 10. Amen. Everyone reading on the screen. For everyone that
receiveth,
and he that
findeth
to him that knocketh, Father, in the name of Jesus. God, I pray this day, this fourth day of the month of February, in the year of our Lord 2024, in this year where we are asking you for more. God, that you would put leap down in our soul. They call this leap year. This only happens, amen, every 4 years. So we know that there's something you're going to do for us that's out of the ordinary. Speak out unto us, edify us, inspire us, illuminate our minds and hearts, and put us for the ministry. We shall carefully live and perpetually give you all praise and all glory. All honor everybody that feel leaping in your spirit. Say in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, I'm trying to get you from where you are to realize it's the season to leap.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Philippians 3 and verse 13 says, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended. But this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are where?
Behind.
And reaching forth unto those things which are before. Same principle. Now, you don't have to use the methods of the past, but you got to realize that God don't want you to remain in the same state that you're in.
Amen.
How many realize it's by divine assignment that you're not going to leave here the same way you came?
Amen.
Amen. Come on and give God some praise for your exit. Hallelujah. Something's going to happen to me here that's going to encourage me. And in verse 14, Paul says to the church at Philippi, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God, where? In Christ Jesus. We got to learn to embrace the new year as an opportunity. Amen. The expanded United We Stand said, I'm not an accident.
Amen.
Amen. There might have been an incident, but I'm not an accident.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. There are things that have happened to me, but I found out that all things work together for the good.
Yes.
If you know it's all good and it's all God, give him a praise right now. There are many things I can't explain. There are many things I don't understand. And there's only a few things, Sister Bowman, that I really know. I know he loved me.
Yes.
And I know he too wise to make any mistake. I told y'all I'm not an accident. And he too just to do any wrong.
Yeah.
So when things happen that seem to be accidental or they seem to be wrong, I don't let it shake my faith. It's just an opportunity for me to leap out of darkness into his marvelous light. Anybody want to go higher in the Lord? Put it in your hand and say, higher, Lord, higher, Lord. This is an opportunity for growth, self-improvement, and positive change.
Yes.
We've been dealing with this. There are 8 things that we told you got to learn to get rid of. Y'all should have them now, amen, in your spirit. They should be, amen, recorded in your electronic device. Number one, we're going to get rid of what?
Negative.
Two? Amen. Your presence, because you'll trip over them, you'll stumble over them.
Amen.
How many know God wants us to have a clear path?
Yes.
Amen. Somebody thank God for straight way. I had to go. Come on and say hallelujah. There's a way that's straight. There's a way that's narrow. But when you are accomplished, amen, hallelujah. Come on, ladies. Anybody ever walk the balance beam? Anybody know that 4-inch wide piece of wood that's there, amen, you can do. I see you, Sister Lee, because I know your history. Come on and say hallelujah. Y'all wouldn't believe she was one of Benedict College, amen, decorated cheerleaders. Amen. Doing all kinds of backflips. I remember in my travel running across a young man, amen, we got to talking and talking, and you know, we trying to place each other. And he was telling me where he's from. Amen. You from the Bronx? I'm gonna bring up the Weaver. Amen. So I said, do you know Courtney? And just so happened, he said, I think she went to school down south somewhere. Yeah, the cheerleader. I said, that's the one. Amen. How many know God has given you a unique identity?
Yes.
He's giving you something that people will recognize you for and give him glory. You're not an accident. God divinely appointed you and gifted you with things that will cause you to walk on the 4-inch beam.
Yes.
Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, you can do it. You can do it. Whatever that narrow path, whatever that straight way that God has assigned for you, you can do it, but you got to put away negativity. You can do it, but you got to put away procrastination. You can do it, but you got to put away self-doubt, toxicity, fear, failure, unhealthy habits, comparison, and club. Clap your hands for doing it in the name of Jesus. Now, this month is February. Amen. They call this Black History Month. Got a problem with that right there. Amen. We're going to deal with the problem. Look at your neighbor and say, they say it's Black History Month. But how many know God has been good to you all year long? All year long. Amen. Y'all gonna give me 1 month?
Right.
And they gonna give me the shortest month
of
the whole calendar. And then it ain't but one time in every 4 years that you can have 29 and never get to 30 and never get to 31. But in spite of what men say, God is worthy of the praise. Showcasing the contribution of Black Americans. Amen. I'm trying to work with this Elder Carney. Amen. Because you know, I wasn't born black. I was born colored. It's on my birth certificate. Amen. A colored boy was born in Fish Memorial Hospital in New Smyrna Beach, amen, Florida. 1962 on the 23rd of August at 6:31 in the AM. Amen. Anybody else was born colored?
Amen.
Come on, let's say hallelujah. I'm born colored. Yeah. You might not know you were born colored, but check your birth certificate. I mean, we didn't become Afro-American until the late 60s and the early 70s. Amen. When everybody got liberated with Ungawa Black Power. Amen. And they started saying all kinds of things, and then we went from colored to being African-American.
Yeah.
And then we graduated in the late 70s and early 80s. We went from African American to being black. Hallelujah. And then we done went from black. And I don't know, I met a fella, he said, I'm swart. I didn't know what that meant. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. It doesn't matter what color you are on the outside. I want to know, have you been born again? Amen. Have you identified with the blood? I'm not a black Christian. I'm not a black preacher. I'm not a black person when it comes to my identity with Christ. Yes, I got black skin. Yes, I preach to a majority black audience. But that's my assignment. But my message is not a black message. My message is not a February 28 days message. My message is not a 29-day
you're going to hear a lot of facts that's going to be based on people's opinion, and it's not going to be the truth. Every year, black folk get this, black folk get the other, black. Amen. I've been black all my life. Amen. You trying to tell me we did this and we did that. In other words, you trying to replace being under to being above. So all of a sudden, you going to walk around feeling you better than everybody. Amen. You going to walk around feeling like, amen, everybody should, amen, give to you.
I'm trying.
Amen. How many realize the 40 acres and the mule is not the answer to your problem?
Amen.
Come on and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This government just today, Sister Riley, amen, gave us 40 acres and a mule. What do you think most of us going to do with it? Why are y'all hesitating? Look at your neighbor and say, I know us. I know us. Black History Month is an opportunity for us to grow. It's an opportunity for us to embrace the fact that the devil meant it for evil, but God had goodness in it. So Carl G. Woodson wanted, amen, American history not to negate or to blot out the history of those that came here in chains, came here in bondage, but have accomplished great things. If you know God have blessed you to be blessed and highly favored, give him some glory. Amen. My home is. Y'all ever heard of that Florida governor?
Yes.
He's a rough guy.
Yes, he is.
Amen. And he said something concerning my ancestors. He said, amen, y'all need to thank God for slavery. Because slavery brought to you a skill set. And then there are some people, amen, who argued against it. And I understood what he meant, and I do know what he said. Now, he meant that I should learn to appreciate the fact, amen, that they taught us to be carpenters, taught us to be tailors, taught us to be, amen, woodworkers, amen, people who learn it. Amen, but when y'all caught me, I knew how to build things. Amen, when you came and interrupted my life, I already was gifted. How many realize God is going to use your gift in order to give him the glory? Oh, I wish I had somebody that knows God has been good to you. Give God some good praise and say hallelujah. But what you did not understand, Governor DeSantis, that God used my weakness. I didn't know the culture. I didn't know the language. I didn't know anything. You took me from my homeland and planted me in the land and gave me subject, made me subject to somebody else. But in spite of all that you tried, I still rise. In spite of all that you said, I still give God the glory. Is there anybody who want to give God glory for the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria? Come on and say hallelujah. The Lord brought me out. Once you understand who God is, Jada, you can learn to thank him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They might try to hurt you, but you got a prophet in your life to let you know that God has been good to you. From the first time I laid hands on you, I identified with a spirit that's a lot older than you are. There's something that was transferred down from your mama and your grandmama that your great-grandmama got hold of, and that's the Holy Ghost. And the promise is not only unto you, but it's unto your children. That's why I wanted to call you now that we stand, because I want you to know the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, if it dwell in you, it'll quicken your mortal body. Come in, your God is shaking you up right now. Go ahead and touch somebody and say, this is the power of God. This is the power of God. The Bible says that, amen, one can chase a thousand.
Yes.
and Duke and Chase 10,000. Carl Woodson's goal was that we would rally around the fact that we don't have to worry about what they did to us, but identify what God has given unto us. Amen. One of the tricks of the enemy is to get you to focus in on what you don't have. Amen. He came to kill, steal, and destroy. And anytime you worry about what you don't have, you're telling God, amen, I'm going to put what I don't have above what I do have. Amen. I might not have a lot, but what I do have, I'm going to give God glory for it. Amen. Amen. So in 1926, he launched the Negro History Week.
Yeah, that's about how it is. They give you, amen, a little bit. Amen. But I see you, Brother White. Amen. They didn't teach you at that school, huh? Thank God for straightway. They gave it a week.
Hallelujah. And then the week was focused around the birthdays of Abraham Lincoln, slave owner, and Frederick Douglass. Y'all know he
like that other skin. Come on and say hallelujah.
Amen. And so once we understand the significance of a man born in slavery, and a man who owned slaves. But the focus of this month is to remind you, if you were up or if you were down, realize that God has given you the ability to come out of whatever situation.
God has allowed you to come through. How many know God will bring you out?
Amen. Do y'all believe that out today? Do you believe God will use your prison experience to give you a testimony? He gonna use your hospital experience. Come on, Sister Ingram, to give you a witness. Amen. Look around on that. 1, 2, 3, 4. On row 4 and row 5. Amen. It's almost filled up.
Yeah.
Now, before December 2019, it wasn't going to be like that. But God had to allow you to go through some hardship. So the things that you were saying in your mouth, that folk could see the hand of God that was on your life. Somebody need to thank God for what you going through. To Black History Month. Again, they just gave him the shortest month. And they do get the 29 days. So this year, everybody say leap year.
Leap year.
I want to use this as a text on asking. Matthew chapter 15, verse 22. The Bible says, and behold, a woman of Canaan. Those Bible students that know the land of Canaan. Amen. Mark chapter 7 calls her the Syro-Phoenician woman. Just trying to identify, amen, that she was a little different. Amen. How many thank God for Canaan land?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Now, once you understand the land of Canaan, you've got to understand that there are some folks who have taught, amen, that Ham's descendants were cursed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because of what Ham did, and the curse came upon him. And don't you know they still try to tell you you got cursed by your color? You are cursed by the fact that you were born in a certain neighborhood. Amen. They tell you about red light districting, red line districting. Amen. And most of us, matter of fact, if you look at the Church of our Lord Jesus Christ, that's how we find out where we're going to put a church, right where the red line was. Come on and say hallelujah. We go right in the midst, because I want the people that have been treated the worst. I want the people that have been ignored. I want the people that realize that they don't have nothing else that they can depend on, to let them know God is going to lift you up.
Yes.
Amen. How many know God can do it? Come on and say hallelujah.
Yes.
If the truth be told on the street, amen, the 40 acres in the mule, no, the government didn't give it. Amen. But those of your generation, those of your parents' generation, amen, they worked hard and they labored and they left acreage, they left houses. They left land, but we were so happy that we could sit with everybody else on the bus that we forgot about we owned our own buses. I come to tell you that you shouldn't worry about what other folk can do for you. You got to learn what God has already done for you. And if God has done it for you, I can do it for myself. He don't have to do anything else for me. I'm going to give him the glory anyhow. How many know if he don't heal your body, you're going to thank him for healing anyway? And I heard but it's called the land of promise, amen, because this is where God told the children of Israel, amen, through Abram, told them, I'm going to show you a land flowing with milk and honey. Amen, but most folk don't understand is that there won't be people in the land. And even to this day, folk are still fighting over the land. And the reason they fight over the land, because it's a family fight.
Look at your neighbor and say, stay out of the family fight. Stay out of the family fight. You're going to be messed up trying to pick side. Oh, your family ain't like my family.
Well, the worst thing you can do is pick a side between the two arms.
Hallelujah. Because you're the one going to get put out. You're the one that's going to get misunderstood.
All I was trying to do is bring y'all together.
Oh, you always like her more than you like me.
Well, family fight. How many know that enough churches around the city of New Haven that every sinner need to be saved? Every person that don't have should have. Amen. But somebody on this corner, somebody on the other corner, but not at 37 Market Street. God bring us together that we can worship in the beauty of holiness. I'm not happy about what I don't have. I thank God for what I do have. Come on and say glory. Come on and say hallelujah. God is doing something amongst you.
You got to recognize this is the hand of God. Everybody say a mortal came.
And she came out of the same coast and cried unto him, ask, and you shall receive. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be open. All right? So, as we look at this text, amen, the woman came out of the same coast and cried unto him. Now, when a woman starts crying, that means she really asking. Have you cried out to the Lord?
Yeah.
I mean, have you really cried out?
Yes.
Have you ever been in a needy situation where you cried out to the Lord?
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Once you get to that point and you cry out to God, you pour out your soul.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
You pour out everything within you.
Oh, yes.
The psalmist said, I cried to the Lord.
Oh, yes.
And he delivered me.
Yes.
And her cry was like this, a question. Have mercy on me. Oh Lord, thou son of David. But catch it.
That's Sister Smith.
Have mercy on me.
Yeah.
Oh Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. Have you ever cried to God for somebody else?
Yeah.
Have you ever cried out to God for somebody in your family? I want to give you a chance right now. If you know there's somebody in your family that's dealing with a demon, that's dealing with demonic influence, how many know we got the authority here to pray and God will deliver them? Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say glory. I wish you would be bold enough in God and cry out to God. Gonna receive. Everyone that seek, you gonna find. Everyone that knock, the door gonna be open. I don't wanna go home and he still be in the same condition. I don't wanna go back to the house and the things haven't changed. God, I come to 37 Market Street and I want you to do something today. Never change, but methods do. And Jesus in verse 23. But he answered her not a word. Sometimes it looks like God is not listening. He don't care.
Amen.
That's what people try to tell you. Some who get real angry. You know, Tyler Perry had it 15 years ago. And I hope it wasn't nobody else's diary, but the diary of a man, black woman. Look at your neighbor and say, well, that's your diary. Amen. There's a lot of things that make people angry. Our brothers, just angry.
Yes.
Sean, you don't know none of the brothers, do you? Angry brothers.
Very angry.
You know, I mean, they'll kill you over nothing.
Amen.
I mean, feeling real big and bad because you got a car. You ain't got no license. They'll break into your house to steal and go to rent a wheel. They don't even buy a wheel. They just rent the wheel. So that when they stop, the wheel can keep spinning. The devil got you all caught up in the things of the world. You got Gucci, you got Lucci, and you got everything else, but you don't have nothing on the inside.
Y'all gonna help me talk this one, huh?
Yes.
And it seems like we're in a point that God does not care. I'm crying to the Lord. Why do you keep going to that church? It's just a white man religion. You just go in there and ain't nothing happen. All the preacher wants to do is get your money. And you done let somebody, amen, who doesn't have a solution to their problem.
Amen.
Tell you how to get your problem fixed.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah. Well, I found out that the name of Jesus is a strong tower. The righteous run in and they are saying, no, they haven't treated us right. But God has never, 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 never let us down. God has never forgot about us. How many know you can say, swing low, sweet chariot? How many know God will reach way down and pick you up? Come on and give God some glory for what he brought you out of. So you done let some angry man encourage you with a few facts that he done distorted. Let me show you how they distort the facts. Brother Bryant, whenever they talk about slavery, they only go back to the 1700s. Rarely they'll go past the 1600, the 1619 project.
Amen.
But if you really understand slavery, it's a lot older than 1600 years.
Amen.
You can go back to the beginning of civilization. And guess who was enslaving who? Folk that look just like you. Come on and say hallelujah. They were all in the same country. Them folk, they could have smelled them before they ever got off the boat. But they had made up in their mind that in order for them to show their deity, the only way I can feel like I'm God, I got to make you feel like you got to worship me. And that's why I don't hang around nobody that think they better than me. I don't hang around no church, no situation where I just feel tolerated and not appreciated. I can walk on the 4-inch balance beam. God has been good to me. And if you don't recognize my gift, amen, I got to see it, don't want to be there. How many of you know that God has been good enough to you that you can learn to go where you are appreciated? If you remember how God is appreciating you in this house, look at somebody and say, I appreciate your presence. I appreciate your presence. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. I got to journey on here. Amen. But this woman, amen, who was an outsider, but she had a problem that she wanted to bring to Jesus. Now, we don't know because the text is not very clear as to how she knew Jesus was a healer, how she knew what he would do. But I just believe that with every need, there is a miracle.
Yeah.
I believe with every problem, there is a purpose.
Yeah.
And I believe that in the city of New Haven, the Fairhaven section, there are people that are watching you because they know you got an answer to their need. Amen. Don't worry about what color they are. Don't worry about what, amen, ethnicity they are. Amen. If they're looking at you, look back at them and say, look on us. See where they go, have I none. But such as I have, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up. But you got to be willing to touch him. You got to be willing to help them. How many realize God has been good
can help somebody. Come on and say hallelujah.
Jesus didn't say a word. Now he's going to answer the lady's situation. And he's going to deal with the lady. But he got to deal with the so-called disciples. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, the church is sick in the head. The church. It is sick in the head. You had to be with me a few years ago. I mean, a few months ago. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Isaiah said, the whole head is sick. And the disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away. For she crieth after us. How bold is that statement? There's nothing in the text that said she was crying after them. She was crying after Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
But there's some folk want you to think that they're the one that's going to heal you.
Yeah.
That's how come they put you in $100 line. I want everybody over here that need a healing. Got $100, I got a healing for you. Okay, after I call $100 line, but maybe you don't have money. Now $100. But I got a $50 line over here. Well, even if you don't have $50, whosoever will, I want you to come. But when you come, don't come empty handed. Anybody heard what I'm talking about today? But I'm so glad that Isaiah said, come without money. And without Christ.
Yes.
How many know ain't no harm done calling on Jesus? Yes. And just try a little bit right now. I want God to put something in your bank account. I'm talking about your spiritual bank account.
Yes.
Everybody in here that know the name of Jesus, call him by his name.
Yes.
God is rich. Yes. Unto all of them that call upon him, you just want one deposit. Amen. But every time I call his name, he keeps filling me up. Jesus, 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 Jesus. When I was telling for the Holy Ghost, Mother Martha, hallelujah, I was telling him from night to night. My mother said when she went in the bedroom early in the morning, I was asleep calling on Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
He's trying to help you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You don't love God?
Yes.
Why are you going to come to the hospital and leave sick?
Amen.
Now, some folk have the wrong mentality of what the doctor can do. I didn't come looking for the preacher. I came looking for the Lord.
Yes.
So Jesus had to teach the preacher. And that's what I believe he did with the pandemic. Say, y'all keep talking about what y'all going to do. I'm going to release a little virus here and see how much you really love me.
Yeah.
Some folk ain't came back to church yet. Come on and say
hallelujah.
They go to Walmart.
Amen.
They go to the movies.
Amen.
They go to school. They go to work. They go everywhere.
Yeah.
But when it comes to the house of God, talk about I'm following the science. You a liar. That's what's wrong with you. Amen. I come to the lost sheep. Everybody say lost sheep.
Lost sheep.
The text is very clear. He's letting the disciples know that this woman is lost. Remember, she did not ask for herself. She asked for her daughter.
Amen.
Remember, she's asking not that he would bring her in. He's asking, she was asking, Lord, just deliver my daughter from this demon.
Yes, Lord.
There's some folk only want what God can do for them.
Yeah.
You don't really want God. Look at your neighbor and say, do you want what he can do for you, or do you want him?
Don't answer, don't answer, don't answer.
Well, I know when your house get on fire, that's when you come looking for it.
Yeah.
When things get in trouble, that's when you show us getting in trouble. Jesus. But the moment this thing is all right, we can't find you.
Yeah.
Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm here to stay. I won't have time to finish. Then came she and worshiped him. The inference of the text, Brother Jones, is that somehow she might have heard them talking to Jesus about her condition. Somehow she might have got an understanding, whether by discernment, that they don't want me to be healed. I don't even want you. I want God to do something for me. I didn't come here to look at you. I came. Then came she and worshiped him. Now, if you go back to the earlier, she was crying out to God. Now she's worshiping.
Yeah.
How many know when you have experience with God and he hasn't answered you? Remember, he act like he didn't even hear her. So she asked. Now she's seeking. Can y'all walk with me a little bit? She's seeking now. She's seeking. She's seeking. Lord, where are you? Lord, where are you? Down here praying. Waiting on you. Down here praying. And I'm waiting on you. Lord, are you here? Are you there? Lord, where are you? I go to the ends of the earth. I go wherever you want me to go. But I got to get deliverance from this child, my inheritance. This child, my legacy. This child.
these three words. Lord, help me. Come on and say, Lord, help me.
Lord, help me.
Till you come.
No, you instituted this love feast
for us. The Hebrews were observing a Passover feast. God, but it's not what can help our flesh. It's what builds our spirit. God, you said, hallelujah, that if we can just discern the Lord's body, Lord, we can leave here healed today. We can leave here delivered. God, even if the affliction is not on me, it's on my family, it's on my children. God, just like you provided healing through your sacrifice, God, heal everything that's connected to me. God, deliver everything that I'm identified with and do it in the name of Jesus. And do it right now. If you know he's a right now, give God, give him a right now praise. Do it, God. 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 Lord, help me. 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 You got to cry out to me. You got to let him know how serious you are. Oh, the Holy Ghost is here right now. The Holy Ghost is in the house right now. Don't play with God. Don't play with God. Don't play with God. I know the church don't want you to get to deliverance. I know there are people who say you're not worthy. But I come to let you know who's listening. He's watching. You got to knock. God is opening some doors. Amen. To your employment, he's opening doors. To better relationships, he's opening doors. To better engagement, you need to worship God and walk through the door. You need to worship God and give him the understanding. Lord, I'll do what you say I should do. According to your promise, in Jesus' name, those that desire to suffer with the Lord. Hallelujah. Follow the directions of the usher. Come. Amen. Get a chalice. Amen. Return to your seat. Hold it until, amen, we all eat together. Come on. First Communion said, and it could only serve 25 people. And I remember when we had to get the second set, and the third set, and the fourth set, and the fifth set. I was so glad that we ran it out of wine. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. God is a good God. He waited on you, y'all.
Amen.
Yes. He waited on you.
Yeah.
He's waiting on you. This has been prepared for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One more time, everybody say, Lord, help me. Lord. Thank you for your body that was broken. Blood that was shed for us. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. On this month of February, God help us. In the same night that Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he broke it. Take the chalice, turn it upside down. Where you see the bread, remove the lid from the top of the bread. Take the bread, put it in your hand. Take and eat this body that was broken for you. Turn the chalice over. After the same manner, he also took the cup. Take the lid off the wine. This cup is the New Testament of blood that was given for the remission of sins. Drink ye all of it. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink of the Lord's cup, you do show forth the Lord's death and his suffering until he comes! Come on, put a seal on it. Say, in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank God. God is a good God. Thank God for all of you. Thank God for, amen, what he has done for us. Amen. I encourage you, draw nigh to God. Because he's drawing nigh to a remnant. There's some folk that didn't do like this woman did. I'm going to do more with this. Look at your neighbor and say, no more crumbs.
No more
crumbs. This woman had a desire to ask, to seek, and knock.
Yeah.
There's certain things you have been assigned by God.
Yes.
And the only way you're going to get them, you got to keep moving. Yes. Somebody say more in 2024.
More.
Say, son of him, without Mount Olive. We don't have a Mount Olive to go to, but thank God for Market Street.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
So we want you to embrace one another on your way out. Amen. Let your brother, let your sister know God sent me to help you. God sent me to help. So stand to your feet, greet one another. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Greet everybody in Jesus' name. Tell them that you love them in Jesus' name. We can work together in Jesus' name. Everybody smile. Jesus. Everybody smile. Jesus love. Oh, greet everybody in Jesus' name.
I saw you back there. You was...